To determine the derivative of the given function, we'll have to apply the quotient rule, which is given here. So we'll let the numerator equal f and the denominator equal g. So we'll go ahead and write out the quotient rule, and then we'll determine the derivatives of f and g. So to determine f prime of x, we'll start with the denominator. Notice this is going to be the denominator squared, so we'll have the quantity 9x plus 1 squared. And then we'll have g times f prime minus f times g prime, where the denominator times the derivative of the numerator plus the numerator times the derivative of the denominator. So now we'll determine the derivative here of the exponential and the derivative of the polynomial. So for f prime of x, the numerator is going to be 9x plus 1 times the derivative of 3 to the power of 2x. This is a composite function, so we'll have to apply the chain rule. Our derivative formula is here. So notice that a is equal to 3, u is equal to 2x, therefore u prime is equal to 2. So the derivative of 3 to the power of 2x will be natural log 3 times 3 to the power of 2x times u prime, which is 2, minus 3 to the power of 2x times the derivative of 9x plus 1, which is just 9. Now let's determine this product here. We'll have the product of these 3 times 9x, that's going to be 18x, natural log 3 to the power of 2x. Plus the product of these 3 times 1, which will be 2 natural log 3 to the power of 2x. And then we'll have minus 9 times 3 to the power of 2x. The last step here will be to factor the numerator. And notice the greatest common factor of these 3 terms is the exponential 3 to the power of 2x. So we'll take this over to the next slide and factor this out of the numerator. So if we factor out the exponential, we'll be left with 18x natural log 3 plus 2 natural log 3 minus 9. So this would be our derivative function. I hope you found this helpful.